welcome back to my channel. So first and foremost, say hello to little Bodie Gator. Giving some little head rubs, yeah. Well, today's video is not gonna be about Bodie or crested geckos. It is about hermit crabs. I thought I'd let him hang out with us a little bit while I film, since he's such a good boy. Here, let's put you right here and you can just chill out. You be a good boy while I answer some questions. So I've been getting tons and tons of questions from you guys recently regarding hermit crabs and hermit crab care. So I thought that I would take the ones that I'm asked the most frequently and put them into a video and answer them for you guys. Just a quick disclaimer before we get into the video, in no way, shape, or form in this video am I encouraging you to go out and buy hermit crabs if you do not already have hermit crabs. This video is just meant to be a helpful tool for people who have questions about them if they already have them or have had them for a very long time. Please remember that all of these answers are my opinion. They are just what I have learned, researched, and found that works best for me and my crabs over the past 9 years that I've had them. Okay, so the first thing we're going to talk about is hood lights. How often do I leave my hood light on and how much light should hermit crabs get during the day? So generally, I leave my hood light on about 12 hours a day and then I turn it off at night before I go to bed.
Ooh, you being such a good boy.
Now, obviously, if you live in a colder climate, you may want to put an undertank heater on the back of your tank just to give it some extra heat at night to make sure that it doesn't drop too low. But for me, I live in the south, so I don't use any additional heat other than my heat light. And again, I keep it on during the day, and when I go to bed at night, I just click it off. So the next question that I get the most is about salt water. There's a lot of confusion about salt water in the hermit crab world, I'm finding. I get a lot of questions asking what kind of salt water, where do you get it, can I use ocean water, all types of things. So we're gonna talk about all of that right now. So the number one question I get regarding salt water is, can I use salt water from the ocean? I have people commenting all the time in surprising numbers saying that they're going to the ocean on vacation and they're filling up jugs of water and they're taking it back for their hermit crabs. I have to say, I do not recommend doing this at all. Something that you have to understand regarding hermit crabs and salt water is that everything in the ocean is part of a perfect ecosystem. You've got your good and bad bacterias, you've got planktons, you've got corals, you've got reefs, you've got algae and fish. Everything in there works perfectly together to form that ecosystem. He's getting a little wiggly. So the problem with taking salt water from the ocean is you're only taking one little piece of that ecosystem and you're not taking the rest of it with it. So whenever you take it, you're getting a little bulk of bacteria and algae and fungus and things and other pathogens. He's moving. But you're not taking the good with the bad. You're just taking a piece of it. So when you put that water that's unfiltered and unclean into your hermit crab tank, he's like, really? I'm gonna go put him up now. Say bye-bye. Say bye-bye, Bodie. Say bye-bye. So basically, by taking a piece of the ocean, you're not taking the good with the bad. You're just taking a small portion of that salt water that has living algae and bacterias and pathogens and pollutants and who knows what else, and then you're putting that in your hermit crab tank. Now, is it possible to make ocean water sanitary? Sure, I'm sure you could leave it out and then you would have to drain it, you would have to let it sit, you could skim off the top, you're gonna have to test the salt, you're gonna have to test the alkalinity and all of these other things, but that's gonna take so much time and effort, and is it really worth risking the health of your hermit crabs? Probably not. So if I were you, I wouldn't use salt water from the ocean. I know it seems like a great idea and that it's convenient, but the fact that land hermit crabs don't live in the ocean, they don't live in salt water. It's merely something that they visit and maybe soak in or drink from occasionally. It's just easier and more sanitary for your crabs if you use an instant ocean powder that you mix yourself, or if you wanna use a salt water in a bottle like I do from the pet store. Anything other than ocean water is gonna be fine for your crabs. The same with sand. I get a lot of people asking, can I take sand and salt water from the beach and use it for my hermit crabs? The problem with taking sand from the beach is that it is an uncleanly sand. It's part of an ecosystem, like I mentioned. You've got bacteria and organisms and little animals and things living in that sand. Now, obviously, if you want to bake the sand, make sure you sift the sand and things like that, you can go through measures to make that sand okay for hermit crabs. But again, it is just easier to buy some play sand from the local store or pet store, not calcium sand, mind you. But in regards to using ocean water, I just wouldn't. I would avoid it personally. So the next question I get all the time is, are painted shells safe for my hermit crabs? So the short answer is no, absolutely not. I would never recommend keeping your hermit crab in painted shells or offering them painted shells to change into. The reason that you see hermit crabs in painted shells is a marketing strategy of the hermit crab industry. Something that I absolutely do not support. Now, I know you guys are like, wait, you have hermit crabs, you make hermit crab videos, you're supporting this industry. No, actually, I've had my hermit crabs almost 10 years, and while I love my hermit crabs and I will continue to make helpful videos for those who have had their hermit crabs for a really long time, or maybe they've been giving the hermit crabs or they rescued them or something like that, I do want to offer information that is helpful to those so that those hermit crabs can have a long and healthy life. I do understand that people are still going to buy hermit crabs, and 9 times out of 10, they're going to come in these flashy painted shells that are actually completely toxic for them. So in a nutshell, no pun intended, basically the hermit crabs are caught from the wild and they're placed into these really toxic painted shells that are absolutely not good for them. The paint and the shine that is put on these shells is actually extremely toxic to hermit crabs. As they get in and out of their water and salt water, this paint actually chips off into the water and then it can actually kill your crab. And that is one of the many reasons why painted shells are horrible. Now, one thing I do want to mention briefly is there is a difference between a painted hermit crab shell and a polished shell. So I have seen a lot of people get this confused, but there is a difference. Painted shells are hand painted with a toxic paint that is not safe to hermit crabs that will eventually chip off. A polished shell is just a shell that has been buffed and shined to give it a really pretty shiny exterior, and usually there are no chemicals used to do this. Obviously, I'm sure some people may use a wax or something, so you're just gonna have to be mindful of where you get your polished shells from. Now, one thing to mention with the polished shells and using sand in your tank, don't be surprised if you use sand with your hermit crabs and your polished shell over time becomes really, really dingy and it doesn't have that pretty pearly polish anymore. This is not toxic to your crabs whatsoever. It's just that sand is very gritty and it is going to wear on that shell over time, and it's basically just going to take away that really pretty buffer that was on there in the first place. Currently, two of my hermit crabs are in polished shells and they have no problem with them whatsoever. They are not toxic and they're really pretty to look at. So that is something to remember if you happen to use polished shells in your tank. Okay, so the next thing we're going to talk about is the question of EcoEarth or sand. I get so many comments, it's crazy, telling me that my tank is not appropriate for hermit crabs because I choose to not use sand. However, after 9 years and 3 healthy crabs later, I can confirm that it is okay to use EcoEarth and not use sand if that is your personal choice. I just want to be clear regarding the EcoEarth and the sand debate that has been going on in my comment section on my hermit crab videos. You do not have to use sand if you do not want to. It is a choice. In fact, if you go on the Hermit Crab Association, which is the very website that you all have suggested I read time and time again, it says you can use EcoEarth, play sand, or a mixture of the two, meaning you can use EcoEarth by itself, you can use play sand, or you can use the two together. It is a personal choice. However, whichever one of those you choose, your hermit crabs are going to be just fine. EcoEarth does work. They can molt, they can dig, they can do tunnels. It will be fine, I promise. So to everyone who's been leaving me comments and links to the Hermit Crab Association website, I just want to let you guys know that I did read it, I've got a handle on it, and I really appreciate it. Okay, so the last question that I get asked all the time that I want to talk to you guys about today is people asking me, is my crab molting? Is it dead? Is it missing? What's going on? I haven't seen it in 2 weeks. So the one thing to remember about hermit crabs is not all hermit crabs are created equal. Hermit crabs can be out, be very active, be very social, or you could get a crab that's more shy and timid, doesn't want to come out, is scared of you. If it's new to its tank, if you've only had it a couple days, they are very likely to go under, bury, and then not come up for a week or two at a time, even if they're not molting. Now, obviously, if your hermit crab is molting, you don't want to disturb it. You want to leave it be. When it's done shedding, leave that exoskeleton, and then after a week or two, you will probably see that hermit crab emerge, maybe be a little bit lighter in color, but you will see it come back up and go back to its normal life. Now, I know that this can be a scary time. If your hermit crab has buried itself and you haven't seen it in a few days, if it's not touching its food or water, and it's been 3 days, 4 days, or whatever, and you're kind of getting worried, it could either be molting, it could be scared, de-stressing, and just getting acclimated to its new environment if you just recently got it, or it could just be wanting to be buried for no reason whatsoever, and that's okay. I promise you, your hermit crab knows what it's doing. Obviously, there is the off chance that your hermit crab is new to its tank, or it's been overly stressed or overly handled, or it's been picked on by a bigger crab in the tank. But the main thing I want to assure you guys of is if your hermit crab is dead, which is something that a lot of people have been asking me, I think my hermit crab is dead, I haven't seen it in a couple weeks. I just want you to know that if your hermit crab is dead, you will know. If your hermit crab has passed, unfortunately, it will start to smell really, really bad. There will be a stench of dead fish in that tank that you will not be able to escape. So if you go to check on your hermit crab and you haven't seen it in a few days or a week and you're wondering if it's dead or not, if you don't smell anything, I would just leave your crab be and let it finish doing whatever it's doing. If it's de-stressing, if it's just hiding because it's scared and it's getting acclimated to a new tank, if it's molting, whatever the case be, I would just leave your hermit crab alone and trust that it knows what it's doing, and when it's ready, it will reemerge and it will start eating and drinking and walking around like normal. The main thing to remember with these little guys is they're really hardy. They're a lot hardier than you think they are. They're not gonna just die for absolutely no reason. It's usually a cause of sickness, stress, or some other type of illness. If your hermit crab tank is set up properly and you're following all the guidelines, you should have nothing to worry about, and just give it time and your hermit crab will reemerge. Okay guys, that is it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope that all of these hermit crab questions and answers helped you guys a little bit and maybe clarified some of the questions that you guys have been asking me. Please remember, all of these answers are my opinions, experiences, and what I've studied over the years. So I hope that this helped you. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys in my next video. Be kind. Bye.